Hey everyone, welcome everyone. We've won the rules, so we're gonna go ahead and play first. Don't have any lands here, so we're gonna go ahead and mulligan that. This hand is pretty bad. Going to five is not optimal. I think the odds of drawing two lands in a row. Well, we've got 16 more lands in the deck, four one drops, so we've got basically 20 out of 34, which is a reasonable amount, but I can see going to five. This is perfect. So we're gonna go ahead and play this and level up. So if we draw any spell, we're in good shape. Barring this dying, then we're in like pretty bad shape because we've already double mulled. So, oh gosh. Is that scary? So I think we're just gonna go ahead and explode out of the gates here. Play our Wall of Roots, play our Llanowar Elves, and then just level this bad boy up, and we'll have two, four, almost eight mana now. I'm not going to bother attacking, I just want to like get as much mana as available as possible in the case that we end up drawing something sweet. Alright, so he's playing Halimar Depths and has decided to order everything the way he will. Yavimai Elder, that's not bad. So I think we'll just go ahead and play that guy and crash. Probably sack him for plains and a mountain so we can fix our mana. So we'll go ahead and cast that dude. Hold off on leveling for now. And all of a sudden, we're back in the game, turning his Blighting into a useless card. A Morph? That could be Bane of the Living. That would certainly be bad. So I'm going to go ahead and pop this guy for some manas. You want to use the ability? Kind of. So we'll get all of our stuff. And go two. Three, four. We can actually level this guy all the way up to five. So I think we'll do that. Yeah, more land. That sucks. So I think we're just gonna level this guy up to five. Level. 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 So if this guy dies, if that is Bane of the Living, then see this guy's a 1/4, this guy's an elf, so he taps for a lot of mana. So all we need is something sweet. Jeez, this guy's lands are pretty sweet. Volcanic Island, Polluted Delta, Blood Crypt. It's got a pretty nice mana base. And a Vampire Nighthawk, a card that I care absolutely nothing about. So let's see. At this point, I don't mind trading. Well, I'm going to hold this guy back and probably block his Nighthawk. So I think for now, I'm going to go ahead and play this Mountain and the Coalition Relic. Sort of chill on the back burner right here. This is one of the problems of having a bunch of mana sources in your deck. You can draw a lot of them, and it ends up sucking. All right. Don't really want to take a bunch of damage, so I'm gonna go ahead and kill this Nighthawk potentially. Reach for the skies, my friend. Oh, he's doing something. Excellent. It's kind of what I wanted him to do. And let's go ahead and put a charge counter on this because why not? Ooh, that was sweet. Add a mana. We'll go for some of that. Play an Oracle, which is also an elf. So we're probably going to be drawing gas from now on. Do you have a counter? Xenagos. Well, Xenagos isn't that great against a flying vampire Nighthawk. So I think for now I'm just going to go ahead and play a land and then shut the turn because the morph is being somewhat problematic. Just make sure this has got a level 5. Yeah. So next turn, ooh, end of turn brainstorm, the most opportune time of all times. I really dislike end of turn brainstorms. They're just not that great. It costs so little, and so now you're gonna see one less card, and if you're, yeah, just, it's not nearly as good as playing main phase. And steam vents, man, this guy is just has everything. Really? Oh, my. What is going on? 6 mana. All right, so suppose that this is going to be bad if he has a Vesuvian Shapeshifter, because he could copy his Nighthawk. Maybe he wants me to block with Wallaroots. I don't actually mind doing that, I suppose. I could see it being like Bane of the Living, in which case blocking with Wallaroots is fine. Could block with Oracle and Lanowar, but I really want this to clear the top of my library. I don't think I can afford to draw lands for the rest of the game. So I'm fine with losing my Wallaroots here. And he calls. Doesn't have anything. I call. He doesn't have anything. Let's see what this is. And it's a Bane of the Living for X equals 2. Sure. Oh well. I really don't want to play against that. So now we can Xenagos and then add red. I don't think I want to do that just yet. I would just not play this. So I think I'll attack for one. Because I'm not going to be blocking anytime soon. Yep. Okay, so this game is probably going to be not ours. Let's see what he's got. Go for the throat, Bane of the Living. Yuck. We're going to be bringing in restock. Probably smokestack also. Glenlyndra Archmage. Just what the doctor ordered. Okay, let's play Xenagos. What do you have to say to get for that? Okay, we're gonna play Wood Elves and then get a forest. And hopefully draw something next turn that'll get us back into this game. We have to block his Bane of the Living with our Wood Elves. Otherwise, we'll take too much damage and die to flyers. And he's got 4 cards in hand. Yep. Okay, let's see. What do we want? Well, I think we can probably cut. Well, we can add these. We can probably cut a land. And something else. A land and a borderland ranger? Is that what we're going to cut? I think we'll try that. Cut Chaos Warp. It's sort of my go-to for creature removal though, so I'm going to try that.